You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
The community by the community.
It's spring, it's March, it's Women's History Month, and I have in the studio with me some empowered women of greatness. Don't touch that remote, right? Back in a second.
Get ready to find hope. Get ready to be inspired. Get ready to discover your full potential. Get ready for total success from the Total Success Coach, Princess Bola Adelani.
This is Princess Bola, the Total Success Coach, welcoming you to Inspired Success, your monthly dose of inspiration power, the program that equips you with the power and inspiration for total success. That is success at work and in life. And yes, I said it is March, it's spring, and March, it's Women's History Month. And you know that is a subject very, very dear to my heart. The whole women empowerment and advancement movement. It's a movement, you know, and you know that I'm on the forefront when it comes to women and women empowerment. So guys, don't be jealous, but you can watch, you can tune in, because you know what? You probably came into this world via a woman, right? You did. And so come on, tune in with us and watch today's show. And I have in the studio with me some amazing, amazing women. And we're going to be having this conversation about, you know, empowered women and empowering women as one of my guests calls it, of greatness. And, you know, we're featured this month in her magazine, and we're giving some awards. And so we just want to talk about the whole evolution of the woman and, you know, where we are now and where we're going from there. And it gives me great pleasure to welcome to Inspired Success the editor-in-chief of Beautifully Inspired Women's Magazine for women over 40, right? Miss Dottie Barnett, right?
Hi, thank you.
Great. It's really great to have you in the studio with me.
Nice to be here.
Thank you. It's a real pleasure. And seated next to her, you're going to find out a bit more about Tawana Lewis. She's a playwright, a pioneer, a trailblazer, an educator, another empowered woman. Really great pleasure to have you in the studio with me, Tawana.
Thank you for having me.
Oh, pleasure, pleasure. And lastly, but definitely not the least, seated next to Tawana is Miss Carolyn Vermont. This woman is just amazing. I mean, her last Facebook cover, she had the First Lady of the United States, Michelle Obama, on the cover. She had taken a photo with her. I'm like, oh, go girl. You know, she's that kind of woman. Another amazing, amazing woman, a leader in our community, doing great and empowering things. It gives me great pleasure to bring you to Inspired Success, Miss Carolyn Vermont.
Thank you.
My pleasure, my pleasure. So we're going to dive straight into this conversation. Okay, and what brings us here is, number one, it's Black, it's Women's History, because I'm still thinking Black History because of February, but it's Women's History Month, and, you know, honored. I'm honored. Dottie has this magazine, BIW for short, magazine for women over 40. And this month you're celebrating, you know, women of greatness and, you know, in honor of Women's History Month. And so, but before we get into that one, you know, conversation about how you came about the nomination, the criteria and all of that, tell me about your magazine. How did you come about the magazine, and why women over 40?
Okay. Well, I've been writing for a very, very long time, and my inspiration for starting a magazine for women 40 and over, after doing some research, I realized that there really wasn't a whole lot of publications out there that women could connect with. And so it is an online publication that I started roughly 3 years ago.
Okay.
And my whole desire was, again, to come out with a publication that women over 40 could connect with. Society have sort of beat women down for a very long time, and having us to believe that once you're 40, you're considered over the hills, as they would say. And so I wanted to come up with a publication that really kind of demolished that whole concept.
Okay.
So that women, you know, other women around the world could see some of the women that we would feature who were doing empowering and inspiring things, such as going back to school over 40, getting married over 40, empty nesters who were becoming entrepreneurs and doing things that perhaps they had to put on the side to raise their families over the age of 40. Some women even having children over the age of 40.
Yeah.
We have models that we feature who are as old as 70 years old, but they look fabulous. So there again, it was a magazine that I wanted women to connect with and to feel that being over 40 is wonderful. It's a beautiful thing to feel good about.
Like they say, 40s is the new 20s, you know? And so I guess that's what you're saying in a nutshell.
No, not really. We're not trying to project being 20 or 30. It's just really being comfortable in your skin.
Yeah, being comfortable in your skin. And the whole idea also, I think, about being, when they say 40s is the new 20s, is that people 40 and over doing things that, you know, they still got the energy, the drive, the zeal that people in their 20s are known to have.
Absolutely.
Which is really what you're saying, that, you know, you want to just highlight the positive.
Absolutely.
The fact that, you know, we're not going downhill once we're over 40.
And feeling good in your skin.
And feeling good about it and owning it and celebrating that.
Absolutely.
Okay, very good. Great, great. And so this month, you are featuring, you are honoring five women, New England women.
Yes.
You know, you call them women of greatness, empowered women of greatness, and I happen to be one of them.
That's right.
Thank you, girl. It's always nice to be honored and be acknowledged and celebrated, which is great. Before we talk about that with the rest of my guests, with Tawana and Caroline, about why it's so important for us to do that, you tell me first, what is the criteria? How did you come about? How do you nominate someone for this kind of honor? What was it you were looking at?
Okay, the magazine within itself, I mean, is a women's magazine. So we're constantly honoring women for all types of wonderful things that they're doing in their lives.
Yes.
But this particular issue, we wanted to highlight women for Women's Month. So, you know, what we do is we scout around for women who are doing exceptional things within their community, like women like yourself who empower other women. Such as Tawana Lewis, who is a wonderful playwright, writer. Yeah, and a lot of her plays are very inspirational, empowering, such as the one that she just recently worked on. And then, you know, we have Carolyn Vermont, who's doing wonderful things in her community, working with the youth, working with the West Indian community. So when I decided to feature, you know, women, it's, you know, going and finding out exactly what it is that they were doing. And it wasn't an easy, you know, it wasn't really easy to narrow it down to five women.
I know. I hear you. And thank you. And thank you. That makes it even more special, I believe. It's not always easy, but you I think you've kind of hit the nail on the head there. You know, so if you're just tuning in, we're talking this month to Dori Barnett, who is the founder and the editor-in-chief of Beautiful Inspired Women's Magazine. And, you know, I happen to be on the cover because I'm one of the five honorees this month. And we just talked about, you know, this, what she was looking for, what is the criteria? And she hit the nail on the head. She talked about, you know, inspiring. Are you empowering others? And are you this kind of trailblazer that's making room for others? Are you like Carolyn, who is constantly looking for give back? I was asking her a question before the show, and her surprise, and her answer kind of took me back, because, you know, as a businesswoman, as an entrepreneur, when I join associations, I'm looking from the at the professional benefit, not always as an opportunity to give back. And she was like, no, I was just there to serve,
right.
You know? So those are the kind of things that you want to kind of have in you if you want to aspire to be in a place like this. And that leads me to my next question, which I'm really going to pose to Tawana and Caroline, and said, you know, you didn't get here overnight. Wherever here is, you know? You know, it's all very subjective. And here for you is not necessarily where here was is Spike Lee, for example, or someone else. They're all still different levels. But for this level, you know, this is a good place where you are. You write your own plays, you stage them and so on and so forth, and you're being recognized in the community. And the same with you, Carolyn. And so how did you get here? What are some of the life lessons that you can share with other women, especially Afro women, you know, who are saying, you know what, I have a dream. I want to be successful. I want to make a difference in my community. What would it be? What nugget of wisdom would you share with someone?
Well, I went back to school. I actually have a degree in theater from Central.
Okay.
And I went back to school with five children. I'm a mother of five children.
Wow.
So.
Okay, you had your first one when you were like 2 years old?
Not quite.
You look amazing.
Thank you. Thank
You're
you
welcome.
So much. So when all of my children, when my youngest one was in preschool, all day preschool, I decided at that point, I'm going to go back to school. Kind of like what Dottie was saying, there are certain things in life that you had to hold off until the time was right. So when my youngest was in all day daycare, I thought to myself, this would be a very good opportunity for me to pursue my bachelor's degree. So I went and did that with five children.
I can't stress this enough, especially if you are a woman of color, or even a man, you know. What you're talking about is education.
Absolutely.
Education, mm-hmm. education. Mm-hmm. Get those qualifications.
Absolutely.
And it's never too, the credentials, they matter, mm-hmm. you know? It's never too late. People are often taken aback. You know, I'm a minister, I'm a life coach and all of that, but I'm also a lawyer. Mm-hmm. I'm a British trained corporate lawyer. And so they'll be like, woo, you know? And it does open doors. Mm-hmm. It gives you the credibility to stand before people and speak. It
Absolutely.
Matters.
Absolutely.
And so you're saying for you one nugget, listen here now, go back, no excuses. She did it with five kids. A young adult.
Yeah. Dean's list two times.
Oh, wow.
So, and, you know, I had to find a balance because
yes.
it was like I had to send them to school.
Yes.
Then it was time for me to go to school.
Yes.
So the semester before I was getting ready to graduate, I was invited to go to Ethiopia for 3 weeks to do some HIV/AIDS prevention workshops. My professor had invited me there. And Meryl Streep had donated a lot of the money to fund us to go.
Yeah.
And prior to me leaving, I was like, okay, this is the last semester. What's my next step? What am I going to do next? So I really wanted to be involved with a lot of the productions at school. However, the rehearsal schedule was grueling. They would be there sometimes till 9 and 10 o'clock at night. And I knew I couldn't do it. I had to
yes,
go home
go,
and
go
I had to
home.
Help
exactly.
with homework and things like that. So I was in my bed, and I believe God spoke to me and told me to do your own productions. So I began to write. You know, prior to that, I really wasn't a writer.
So what is that mm-hmm. other nugget that you're saying? There are two things that before I invite Miss Carolyn into the conversation.
Mm-hmm.
So education. Look in that camera and speak. I say education. We can't say
absolutely.
Absolutely. Our kids have got to stay in school.
Mm-hmm.
We got to pursue higher education, and the higher education.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so, and the other thing is what? You're saying that, am I hearing you say courage to pursue your dream?
Absolutely.
To do your own stuff?
Yes.
Absolutely.
Indeed.
And do something that you love and on your own terms.
Right.
Is that entrepreneurial route?
Yes.
Absolutely. I'm a great believer in that as well. Just have the courage to pursue your passion. And so, Miss Carolyn, you are this amazing woman. You're just all over, just, you know, so well known in the community, doing some amazing things, you know, being on the board with Michelle Obama's Women Movement program and so many other amazing things that you do. So I also know you didn't get here overnight, okay? You didn't get to this place. Give wisdom to someone watching today and say something to them about how you get to a place like this.
Well, I'm truly my mother's daughter. My mother was very involved in the community. I'm from in Jamaica. My mother, she was the postmistress. She owned a store. She had a dance hall. So I grew up watching my mother being involved in just about every aspect of the community.
Mm.
And so I grew to be involved in the community. And I benefited from so many youth organizations. Mm. The NAACP Youth Bridge, which was an acting workshop started by Paul Newman and June Havoc, Upward Bound. So by being a beneficiary of so many programs, it was always in me to give back. And then once I started having children, I made sure I was involved in everything they were involved with. So my daughter was involved with Girl Scout. I was on the Girl Scout board. I was on the PAC officers at their school, the community center they went to. I made sure I got on the board because I always wanted to be in that position to make decisions that affected them. So I encourage people to stay involved. You know.
Okay, so that's the next thing. Engage your community.
Yes.
Just get engaged in community. And it's so amazing that you're saying that. My son is a freshman at, you know, a local high school in West Hartford. And, you know, he loves to play basketball. He didn't get on the team, in the school team. But, you know, I said to him, look for something else that fuels your passion in the school community that you can engage, you know, start engaging. Because once you get engaged, number one, and you start volunteering, you bring yourself, it enhances your visibility in the presence of people who do matter. You position yourself as a leader. If they're looking for someone to give a scholarship, sometimes it's not just all academic, how smart you are academically. Sometimes they look at all the extracurricular and see how engaged you are. And it can really open doors and connect you to the right people. So that's just practical wisdom, you know, right there for you. You know, engage whatever community you find yourself in. Whether you're a working professional, I always tell this to my clients all the time. Engage in your network of your corporation and volunteer and give back. Engage the community. So that's a really good one. You know, we're standing on the shoulders of women who have gone before us, right? And, you know, you alluded to your mom being a huge inspiration for you. Who's your inspiration? Where do you draw your inspiration from, Tawana? And then I'm going to ask you in 1 minute, because you won't believe it, time flies so fast, and we only have a few minutes left. But who's your inspiration? Who inspires you?
I'm inspired by my children, you know, to do positive things and, you know, just to move forward. I'm also inspired by my family. Also,
okay. So family inspires you. What about you, Dottie?
I'm inspired by women.
By other women.
By
other women.
Absolutely.
Yeah. I'm inspired by my faith. My faith, Jesus inspires me. Mm. I'm a real woman of faith, and I draw all my inspiration and my strength from that relationship with Him and the Word and the Bible and all of that. I get a lot of wisdom. And as the more I read, I say Jesus was the one who launched the feminist movement. You know, because people sometimes look at scriptures and think, a lot of people shy away because, you know, of the oppression that they think they read in the scriptures towards women and other ethnicities and all of that. But when I look at it, he came to really break the status quo and the culture. He sat with prostitutes. He allowed that. He ministered. I think he was the pioneer of the feminist movement. So anyway, that's who inspires me, just in case you didn't know. But I think most people who follow me and who watch the show, they know. And so now let's talk quickly about, you know, women running for office and even though we've come a very long way, you know, and I like the fact that every month they take a whole month in the United States and in parts of Europe. I know they do it in England as well. And I think March 8th is International Women's Day or something. So it's actually a global celebration of women. Yeah. And I love the fact that we are being celebrated and honored. Quickly tell me why it's important that we come together and celebrate one another and not be the crab who's trying to pull each person as we're trying to get out back into the bucket. Let's talk about that quickly, as well as talking about women in public office and whether you see that there's still a lot of, you know, inequity and sexism and all the isms going on against women, and we're still earning 77 cents to a dollar, you know, and all of that, and how, you know, we can bridge some of that. But let's talk about just why it's important to have something like this. Yeah. Having a woman celebrating another woman, contemporary women.
I think you kind of hit it on the nail. There again, you know, my inspiration, a lot of it stemmed from my mom, who was a very strong Afro-American woman. And you're right. Women today, I think we don't really stick together enough to empower each other and encourage each other and to support each other, businesses or what have you. We did a wonderful article in one of our back issues in terms of the meaning of friendship, the meaning of empowering other women. And there again, if I could put out a publication that's geared to encourage women in the importance of really how important it is that we do stick together,
then I feel that I've done, that's one of your goals.
Yeah.
So, but why is it important, Carolyn? Why is it so crucial? I don't know whether you're part of any associations or organizations that's really focused on women. In particular, I do a lot of the work that I do really is on women. You know, I have had conferences for the last 8 years, I believe, for women, you know, for professional women, women of faith, women to advance women, to equip women, to mentor women. I've had conferences for young women, you know, that I partner with local colleges and all of that, because for me, it's so important for them, number one, to find people who look like them. Who look like them, who represent the possibilities to them, you know, who look like them. They don't. Some of them don't see enough of them in the classrooms, you know, they don't see enough of them being projected in the media, and the projections are often negative when it's women, you know. So it's important that we all come together and do that. So, but what would you say, why would you say it's important that we...
Yeah, it's very important. I mean, previously I had served as the local chair for the National Political Congress of Black Women. And part of our goal was to prepare women to run for political office.
Yeah.
And when you're talking about role modeling, young people, especially young people, need to see people in positions that look like them.
Yes.
So they have not seen a woman as president yet.
Yes.
But that will happen.
It will. So. I believe it will. I am rooting. I believe it will.
And I'm a strong proponent of mentoring.
Yes.
Especially younger women. For some reason, they may not have confidence in themselves. And
yes.
I think as women in our 40s or above, sometimes we see something in them that they don't see in themselves.
Absolutely.
Or we remember when we were where they are now.
Yes.
And so we have that opportunity to pull them up.
Absolutely. And in 1 minute, in 1 second, actually, we only have about a few minutes left. So with 2 minutes left. In 1 second, what would you say? Why is it important that we need to get out of this mindset of trying to pull down and gossip and, you know how women can be sometimes, and get into a more positive, collaborative, you know, synergy kind of relationship with one another? Why is that important?
Well, you know, I don't think any of us got to where we are alone, right? So
yes.
we all got here because we were supported by someone. by women, right? So, you know, I've learned a lot. And as I get older and as my children get older, I even value my mother even more.
Yeah.
So we are nurturers. You know what I mean? So
yes.
I nurture my children. I'm a teacher. And I nurture those children also. So I think it's innate. It's a part of me. I can't see a child walk by having a bad day or, you know, something going on, and I don't take the time out to say, wait a minute, stop. What's going on? What can I do to help? What can I do to fix? You
exactly.
know?
So you're saying together, everybody
yes.
achieves more. That's
Absolutely.
The acronym for team, right?
We're a team.
Together,
right.
everybody yeah. achieves more. And what I can bring to the table, you cannot bring.
Right.
And you know, when we work together, mm-hmm. we're powerful. We're more powerful together. Mm-hmm. You know, and we can help each other in the areas, you know, where the other is struggling. And I think, you know, the more that the community begins to see collaborativeness, mm-hmm. more collaboration amongst women, I think there will emerge a very powerful, mm-hmm. both economic, political force.
Right.
And so, you know, I really encourage us to really celebrate and come together and come to uplift one another. And so we're out of time. We're not out of words. You already know that these women are so inspiring and amazing. I just want to encourage you to pick up a copy of BWI magazine.
BIW,
I beg your pardon. BIWmagazine.com, right?
BIWmagazine.com.
Yes, BIW, that stands for Beautifully Inspired Women's Magazine.com. It's an online subscription, very affordable. Pick up a copy and you'll read a lot of more about our stories. And, you know, it's just, you know, I had a subscription. I know I'm yet to renew. I think I'm yet to review. But it's very affordable and very, very positive, inspiring. That's what something you need.
Definitely.
I want to invite you to save a date next month, April. I'll be back with another really great show, but my conference is coming up on the 26th. So save that date, Saturday, April 26th. I'll be sharing more with you, but just kind of hold that date in your mind. And I know you're a playwright and your play is in
yes.
June.
Yes, I have an encore production of The Perfect Match, Saturday, June 14th.
And Miss Carolyn has, what is it you have?
With our West Indian American Association, we are having our annual Afro-Caribbean Cultural Family Night.
Oh, geez. I should come there for some chicken, some nice food.
We'll have all that.
Ooh, geez. Oh, girl, y'all making me hungry already. You know, we got to go. You know,
yes.
And you can just connect. You know where to find me. Facebook, I'm there. You know, LinkedIn, you know, Twitter. And, of course, royalproclamations.com. You know, there'll be a link of this video and the link to all their websites. And, you know, we'll be there for you. royalproclamations.com. It's been an amazing conversation. Really nice having you on Inspired Success. Thank you so much
for
your time.
Thank you for
having
us. And
this is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, reminding you to keep smiling. Come on. Put a little smile on your face. Life's too short. Keep learning. Keep networking. Keep believing. Keep on keeping on. You're on the winning side. I look forward to seeing you next month. God bless. Thank you. Bye.